Hello everyone, I am Chef Umesh from Chitkara School of Hospitality and today we are going to learn about culinary terms. In our past topics, we have learned about various culinary basics such as introduction to cuisine, kitchen brigade, hierarchy that is followed in kitchen, some cooking methods, different cuts of vegetables, their classification and some other topics. Now let's learn about today's topic, that is culinary terms. Prior to that, we must know that after learning this chapter, we will be able to answer some basic culinary terms and their definition. And we will be also able to explain about those terms. In that series, the first term comes abats, which is pronounced as a ba or offal. These are internal organs of animals like kidney, brain, tongue, liver, etc. White offals such as sweetbreads, feet, and red offals are heart, lungs, and liver. Another term is alumets, which is also pronounced as alumet. These are very thin French fries. Pomme alumet is a dish made from this cut of vegetable. Next term is anglaise or en glaise. It is a mixture of whole eggs, oil, water, salt and pepper used to help coat food with flour and breadcrumbs. Different dishes like fish a l'anglaise are the dishes which are prepared with this mixture. Another term is al dente. It is an Italian term used to describe the texture of pasta, which is cooked to firm, not soft or mushy, but it should be to the bite, and it is used for the doneness of vegetable and pasta dishes. Au gratin. This is having a browned or crusted top, often made by topping with breadcrumbs, cheese or a rich sauce and passing under the broiler or salamander. We have a picture showing a similar way of gratinating a dish or a pizza under a salamander. This equipment here is known as salamander. Bake. This means to cook foods by surrounding them with hot, dry air, similar to roasting. But the term bake usually applies to breads, pastries, vegetable and fish. And it is done in a confined arrangement, unlike roasting. Barbecue. This is a very famous term in Western countries. It means to cook the food with the help of dry heat. So it is a dry heat cooking method, which is created by the burning of hardwood or coals. Barred. This picture here shows a piece of lean meat being covered with the pieces of bacon or fat. So we can define barred with to tie thin slices of fat such as pork fat back over meats with no natural fat cover to protect them while roasting or cooking. Batter. It is a semi-liquid mixture containing flour or other starch used for the production of such products, for example cakes, breads, and for coating products to be deep fried, as we read in en glaise. Bechamel or bechamel. It is one of the mother sauce used to gratinate different dishes and prepare other sauces like a white sauce mixed with pasta helps in making it more creamy. This sauce is made with the help of thickened milk with a roux and cooked. Beurre manie or beurre manie. It is a mixture of equal parts of raw butter and flour mixed together into a smooth paste. Unlike bechamel or a roux, this beurre manie is never cooked and can be stored for longer duration. Blanch. Blanching means to cook an item or vegetable partially and very briefly in boiling water or in hot fat so that it doesn't lose its texture or crunchiness. Bain-marie. This diagram here shows a setup of bain-marie in which a pan doesn't come in direct contact with the heat. Unlikely, it is cooked with the steam or kept hot with the help of steam. Bain-marie can be defined as a hot water bath. This is a way of cooking or warming food by placing a container in a pot of very hot water. Bouquet garni or bouquet garni. It is a mixture of herbs used to flavor dishes during their cooking. Next up is chinoise, which is a Chinese cooking equipment. It is pronounced as shi noa. This is a China cap sieve or a fine conical strainer. Clarified butter. Clarified butter, also known as ghee in India, this is purified butter fat with water and milk solids removed. Court bouillon or court bouillon. This is water containing seasonings, herbs and usually an acid used for cooking dish or to give them a flavor. Here we have a diagram showing bouquet garni, which is a mixture of fresh herbs, parsley, thyme, bay leaf. These all are wrapped like this in celery and leeks, or they can be tied with the help of a kitchen twine, which is a kind of thread. Sachet de pais, as the name suggests, this is a sachet of different spices such as parsley stems, bay leaf, thyme, crushed peppercorns, etc. Here we have a diagram of showing an onion studded with bay leaf and clove. This is also known as clout or clute. It means to stud or pierce an onion with a whole clove. Another term is chiffonade cut, which you will hear or listen many times while learning about your basic vegetable cuts. It is done with the help of rolling the leaves and cutting them lengthwise in very small thread-like pieces. Chiffonade. Here we have a diagram of emulsion, which is mixing of two immiscible or two unmixable liquids. For example, if we try to mix water and oil, they will leave or they will leave each other or they will remain separate. Larding. This diagram shows a beautiful example of larding in which we insert the fat pieces into the marbled meat, unmarbled meat or lean meat. Unlike barding, it is done inside. Liaison or liaison. This is a thickener or element or mixture used to thicken a liquid or sauce. This process of thickening a sauce using starch such as refined flour, cornstarch, egg yolks, etc. is done to thicken the gravies and sauces. Marinate or marinate. It is defined as to soak a food, particularly meat, in a seasoned flavored liquid. This diagram shows marinated chicken in different spices and oils, etc., so that it becomes tender and absorbs the juices of all the spices. Mise en place. This is a French term meaning everything in place or the pre-preparation that we do prior cooking. Monter au beurre is a term used to cook cubed or frozen butter pieces to give a sauce a shiny finish, or it can be defined as to finish a sauce or soup by swirling in raw butter until it is melted. Pathogen. This is a very important term when we learn about different culinary terms. Pathogen is defined as a bacteria or microorganism that causes disease. However, there are certain microorganisms like lactobacter which are essential or useful for humans. Recipe. A set of instructions for producing a certain dish. We have already learned this term sachet d'épices, which is defined as a traditional French seasoning for soups, stews and meat dishes that typically consists of peppercorns, bay leaf and thyme. It is a mixture which may also include mace, parsley, garlic and onion. Searing. It is a cooking method to brown the surface of a food quickly at high temperature. The reaction that occurs in it is Maillard reaction, about which we will learn in our next slides. Raft. This is the coagulated clear meat ingredients that forms when stock is clarified. It is done usually to clarify our consomme, which is a clear and thin soup. With this slide, we will end our topic of culinary terms. In our next chapter, we will learn about introduction to cooking or introduction to cuisine. For any queries, you may reach out to me at umesh.chukran@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you.